Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2333. Sheet View comes to Win32. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question comes to us from Bob. Bob says, hey, what's the thing that appeared on the View tab out here on the left-hand side called Sheet View? It's been grayed out ever since it arrived, and it arrived in Insider's Fast earlier in May. All right, so there's an earlier video where I talked about Sheet View that came to Excel Online, and I kind of lamented, wow, this is a really cool feature. It's only in Excel Online. Well, here, now it is in Win32. Why is it grayed out? Because it's grayed out because I've saved this file to my local hard drive. So what we have to do, File, Save As, Save to OneDrive, or SharePoint Online. And bingo, it is alive and well. Now, Sheet View is kind of like custom views that we used to have, custom views right here, with a few exceptions. Number one, custom views would never work if this was a table, so Control-T to make it into a table. On the View tab, see, custom views is now grayed out, but this continues to work. Custom views would work across all the sheets in a workbook, but this is just one sheet. So I'm going to come here and filter to, let's say, just Andy. Click OK. All right, and I get just the Andy records. And you see up here, this is called default. Currently, no one else is editing this file, so I actually have to create my own view. First thing I do is I click New. You see the headers turn black, and look down here in the Sheet tab, we get a little eye icon that tells us that there's a sheet view that's been applied to here. It's currently called Temporary View, but if I want to be able to use this and I want others to be able to use this, I'll call it the Andy view, like that. Right, and I can have multiple views. So I come back here, go back to default, and clear the filters, and let's filter to maybe rows. So filter to selected cells value, and I get the rows records. I'll create a new view, and it'll be called rows view, like that. All right, and then I can very quickly jump back and forth between Andy view and rows view, and you can have as many different views as you want. Now, this behavior is actually very different if someone else is editing the file. So here I am in an Excel Online, and now two people are editing this file at the same time. I'll do a filter and choose just Zeke. And here we are. Others are also making changes. Do you want to see sorting and filtering from others? See just mine or see everyone's? If you click see everyone's, this is going to happen to everybody. But if you click see mine, then they're automatically going to create a new temporary view for you, which I could call Zeke only. Now, a couple things. If you make a view, it's not private to you. Anyone who's editing this will be able to choose any of the views. So it's universal across the workbooks. What if at the bottom there had been a subtotal function or an aggregate function, which includes only the visible values? The default view is the official version. That's the one that's going to get saved. Everyone else is just looking at a different version. And the other thing that's unusual here that custom views never did is, let's say that I go into the Andy view, and so we have Andy, and Andy likes to see his data sorted by quantity. So I go into quantity, sort descending. That just moved these records around, but if I come back to another version, someone else who's editing this, those records are still in the original sequence, right? So it's the sheet view that gets the temporary sorting. Pretty crazy that works. So this is different than custom views, certainly necessary if multiple people are editing and each person wants to filter to just theirs. I'm really glad that this came to Win32. I was a little alarmed when it came to Excel Online first, and I thought, oh no, this is going to be one of those Excel Online only features, which I'll never get to see because I don't use Excel Online. But now that it came to Win32, lots of good reasons whether you're collaborating or not collaborating. Well, hey, if you like these tricks, please click like down below in the video, subscribe, and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions in the comments below. And my new book, Mr. Excel 2020, Seeing Excel Clearly, click that I in the top right-hand corner for more information. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.